गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स. एंड इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल स्टडी अबाउट फ्यू एसिड्स, बेसिस एज वेल एट सम सॉल्ट्स एंड देयर डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज एज वेल. सो वॉट इज द कंटेंट, हैव अ लुक ऑन दिस. इन दिस चैप्टर यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एसिड्स, बेसिस, इंडिकेटर्स, पीएच स्केल, केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस, reaction of acids and bases with metals, reaction of metallic carbonate and metal bicarbonate with acids, reaction of acids and bases, reaction of metallic oxide with acids, reaction of non-metallic oxide with base, what is common in acid and in base, salt like caustic soda, bleaching powder, baking soda, washing soda, plaster of Paris and gypsum. These all you are going to study, and these salts name which I have written here, these are the common names of these salts, right? Here we can see the sources of acids. Let's see which are the sources of acids. You can see the vinegar here, the lemon, the tomatoes, grapes, milk and apple, and many more food items and many more household items are there which contain acid, right? Here we have given some examples, like in vinegar you see the acetic acid is present. This is a source of acid, right? Vinegar is the source of acid, lemon is the source of acid. Vinegar contain acetic acid, and in vinegar 5% acetic acid plus 95% of water is there, right? In lemon citric acid is present, tomato has oxalic acid, grapes have tartaric acid, milk has lactic acid, and sap formic acid, apples have malic acid, right? Lemon is considered as citrus fruit, and these all you can see the acids are sour in taste. So vinegar is also sour in taste, tomatoes are sour, lemons are sour, right? So in this way you can find the characteristic features of acids also. See here, this is a chart and it is very interesting to learn in this way the acid, bases and neutrals. Acids, these are the chemicals of important groups are acids, bases and neutrals, right? Acids means acids, bases are bases, neutrals means neither acidic nor basic, right? Many food items and many household items have acids, bases or neutrals. They may be acidic in nature, they may be basic in nature, and sometimes may be neutral. Human tongue can distinguish them by the taste. You know that our tongue has the capability of tasting the food. It can taste sour. It has the glands to taste the different taste of the food, right? Sour, salty, bitter, everything. So in the same way, we can taste these food which we have at home, that whether the food item is acidic in nature or the basic in nature, right? Or the neutral. So dear students, if we are testing the food items, you can test for testing acids and bases, but other than food items, don't test even the household chemicals also. Don't test it, because you can get your tongue can burn, right? Because these may be explosive. Other acids or even bases also may be explosive, and they are corrosive in nature, so your tongue can get burns. So please avoid to taste acids and bases for testing them. Rather than testing by tongue, you can test them with the indicators. One common indicator which you know the name, that is a litmus paper. You know that litmus paper you have used in case of the in previous classes also to test acid and bases. And if you are using blue litmus, right, you are testing blue litmus, in case of acid it will turn in red color, and it will remain same in case of the base, right? If you are using the red litmus, it will remain same in case of acid, and it will change to blue in case of base. Remember always, red litmus changes to blue in case of the base, and blue litmus changes to red in case of the acid. Then you can see the properties of the acids and bases. First of all, see the properties of acids. Acids are solid taste. Acids are having the rough feeling. If you are touching them, you can feel it rough. And acids are corrosive in nature, right? Some examples of acid you can see that fruit juice, vinegar and tartaric acid. Though in case of base, if you see, bases are some examples of bases are soaps, bicarbonate or soda, baking soda, which you can see, bleach, which is used, which is a cleaning agent, you can see. And this is the properties of bases. If you see, bases have the bitter taste, they have the slippery feeling, and they are also corrosive in nature. Though the neutral substances are neither acidic nor basic, they are just neutral. So this is about the properties of acids, bases, as well as their examples. Some common acids and bases, if you see, acids have some common acids are hydrochloric acid, HCl, sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, nitric acid, HNO3, acetic acid, CH3COH. Some bases you can see, sodium hydroxide, NaOH, potassium hydroxide, that is KOH, calcium hydroxide, CaOH whole twice, ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH. So these are the common examples of acids and bases which you will use in case of doing practicals. When you will do in the lab, you will find these acids are there in the lab. Some differences of acids, bases you can see, you can write in the form of differences, like acids are having sour taste, these are bitter in taste, these are acidic in nature, bases are basic in nature, acids don't have the soapy touch, bases are having soapy touch, acids have some sharp smell, though bases do not have any sharp smell, acids have more concentration of hydrogen ion than concentration of hydroxide ion, bases have less concentration of hydrogen ion than the concentration of hydroxide ion. This we will discuss later in detail. And some examples are lemon juice, hydrochloric acid, baking soda, the example of base, and magnesium hydroxide. These are the examples of base. Here you can see these two beakers, and some solution is there in these beakers. You can see in this H plus ions are there, in this OH ions are there. So always remember, H ions means it's an acid, OH ions means it's a base. As per the definition given by Arrhenius, the scientist who gave the definition, according to him, the definition states that an acid produces H plus ions in solution and a base produces OH ion. You can see this is the base NaOH, and you can see it is dissociated in water. When it is dissolved in water, and Na plus ions and OH minus ion, it dissociates into sodium and hydroxyl ions. Whereas this is HCl, when it is dissolved in water, it dissociates into H plus ion and Cl minus ions. So always remember, acids produces H plus ions, whereas base produces OH minus ions. See this slide. In this you can see, when you are writing the examples of acids, these all, if you see the formula, it something is common in these all. What is common? That every acid has some H ions. See, HCl, H plus Cl, H2SO4, H plus SO4 ions, HNO3, H plus ion, and NO3 minus ions, CH3COH, CH3COO minus ion, and H plus ion. In the same way, if you are looking at bases, you can see the formulas. NaOH, it has hydroxyl ion, Na plus OH minus ions, K plus KOH, K plus and OH minus ions, CaOH whole twice, Ca plus and OH minus ions, NH4OH, NH4 plus and OH minus ions. When you are going in lab, you can see that there are some dilute acids and some concentrated acids. Dilute acid is nothing, only when you are mixing water in concentrated acid, it means it is becoming a dilute acid or you are making a dilute acid. So a dilute acid contains a small amount of water, and it has a large amount of water, right? A small amount of acid and a large amount of water, whereas a concentrated acid has large amount of acid and a small amount of water. So in this way, you can recognize what is the, which is the concentrated acid and which is the dilute acid, right?